South Jamaica, baby. They made me to be the greatest, serving the deed of my creators. Fresh off of my high haters, it's the king again. Magdalene chauffeur bragging and boasting.
Yo, what up, y'all? It's your boy Dollars. Welcome back to the channel. It's another day, another dollar video. We back with an Eminem reaction. The song is called Higher. The official video dropped a couple hours ago. The last one I reacted to was Nat. I like that one. I've been listening to the album. There's a few joints that I like a lot. My favorite one, though, is Zeus. I like Zeus a lot. I don't think I heard this one, though. So I may have or I may have it. Like, I'm not sure. But anyway, let's just hop in this joint. Let's see what M is talking about, man. Y'all already know. If y'all been watching some of my Eminem reactions, y'all know how I feel about Eminem, man. One of the greatest to ever do it, by far. It's not even a comparison, bro. Anyway, let's see what he's saying, man. It's called Higher.
Yeah. You know, I've been around for a while now. Not sure if I have much left to prove. Yeah, I do.
He said, I've been around for a while now. I'm not sure I have anything left to prove. I was about to say, no, you don't, man. You still got it, Em. You still spitting better than half the game. Literally half the game. You still spit better than everybody. And then he says, nah, I still do. All right.
Yeah, I do. I look at me now, I'm thinking, damn, how proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France.
What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. M done did a lot in this game. Let's not even mention the record sold. Like, we don't even got to bring album sales into this. Like, just being who he is and everything he's done, he brought us 50 Cent, which in turn brought us G-Unit. You know, drop classic album. Like, come on, man.
How proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France. I look around, I see the fans, how they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands. They're hollering shame.
I could drown in a sea of hands.
That's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all.
My son looking buff right there. I ain't gonna hold you. For a dude that's pushing 50, he's looking like he's taking good care of himself, man. Man, hitting the gym, lifting the weights.
Yelling it out to me, and that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all, man. But in
I flip it around and have the crowd give me a chance. And that's what I mean. Okay, we gotta bring that back. We gotta bring that back.
One day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance,
if I get the chance to get a crowd,
and have a crowd give me the chance.
I've done it all, man.
Give me the.
But in action,
I flip it around and have the crowd give me the chance. He's saying chance, like when you chant out, that's a chant, like when you yell. So they saying shady, they're chanting, but he said chance, and is, you know, come on, man. That was a real simple one.
Flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance.
Give me the chance, but this ain't chance.
But in actuality, I haven't yet.
Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Every time he feels like he hit his ceiling, he goes higher than he's ever been. How far can you push this shit, Em? Because you done, bro. I don't know what else he could say that's gonna make me be like, wow. Like, Eminem done rhymed the whole dictionary already, bro. He done rhymed through the whole dictionary. Every word that you can rhyme with, he done rhymed it. You know, any. But hey, I would never doubt Em, man, because he still is delivering quality even at this day. The last two albums he put out was fire. Music to be murdered by, side A and B, fire. The last one that he did, the Kamikaze, fire. He's been on a roll, bro. Like, I can't even hold you.
Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. Yeah. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Got no time for no haters in this bitch. Or toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital waiting room will get. What I mean is maybe I have more patience than I'm able to admit. Yeah, but I'm still mentally stable.
Like an overcrowded hospital. He has more patience than he's able to admit. Basically, when you admit, like, keep it real with yourself, but he's saying admitting patients into a hospital. More patients that you can admit. When you admit something, you let them come in, but he can't even... Bro, it just takes a different kind of brain to really catch that shit and realize what Eminem is saying. Because he... The littlest line, the littlest word in a bar that you would not expect will have so much meaning in an M verse, bro. Real talk. I just caught that shit myself when I was said it. Admit. You know what I'm saying? More patience than I could admit. I caught that. I'm like, oh, shit. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't even thinking about the admit part, but even the admit bar, that word has a big meaning, bro.
Got no time for no haters in this bitch. What toleration for the shit? Work like medication. My dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital waiting room would get.
What I mean overcrowded is hospital waiting room. I'm able to admit.
Yeah, but I'm still mentally stable. There's a three-legged table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade the shit for the trailer with a hitch that would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause
I made it through my pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler. Come on, fam. Wordplay.
Hitch that would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit danger.
Just cause I made a little bit of change doesn't mean that I changed a little bit. Just because I made a little bit of change doesn't mean that I changed a little bit. Basically, he didn't let the money change him, bro. Not even one little bit. I feel that.
This bitch, but just because I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. And I'm just
brain full of wit can extinguish this English little. Hold up, what?
Changed, don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. And I'm just berating.
English language.
Shady till I'm 82. I spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
So where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I...
He's basically telling the fans, like, where am I supposed to go from all of this? From everything I've done. Like, I don't even have an idea of where I'm going to go from here on out, but all I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I keep going higher than that. Like, I keep surpassing the expectations that people have for me.
I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
I know I talk about this shit a lot, but
where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Man. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Hey.
If we learned anything from watching 8 Mile is that when it comes to battle rap, don't come for Eminem. He will be the first to tell you that he treats the rap game the same way the world's best athletes treat their respective sport.
That's
with
true.
With a 24/7 tenacity that only the elite are able to channel. He spent his entire life studying and training to be the best, but even with a life of preparation, will it be enough for his next battle? It's one thing to conquer your competition. It's another to conquer your demons. With us now to share his thoughts is Dana White, who knows a thing or two about marquee battles. Dana, thanks for being with us. How prepared can one be when going up against an opponent of this magnitude?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Listen, I'm a huge Eminem fan, but this is a tough one. This opponent is not someone you can prepare for. It's a tricky demon to conquer, even for someone as badass as Eminem. My prediction? Is disappointment for fans all over the world.
That's interesting. We are now joined by the man himself, Eminem. Em, appreciate it. What's your response to what Dana just said?
I want to say, first of all, thank you for having me on. I think that people like you give people like me the fuel that they need to succeed in the first place. So I think that the best part about your opinion is that it doesn't matter. And if every fighter that you had listened to your opinion when you doubted them, you wouldn't have a f***ing league. So you're an a**hole, and I'm out.
Well, he definitely sounds ready. In any case, it should be a battle for the ages. Thank you, Dana, and best of luck to you,
Clash
Eminem.
Clash of the Titans.
Now, what am I gonna do? ain't nothing, homie, I'm on the loose. Born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. When my record flops, still go through the roof. This atmosphere is for a chosen few who was on it right.
When my record flops, it still goes through the roof. So a flop for M is like, what, 1 million and 2 million records sold? Like, what's a flop? Because even when he flops, he's still going doing numbers with his albums.
Making money moves, and you ain't gonna get there if you water down. You gotta take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode since a 5-year-old. It was I alone since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone.
Been in survival mode since 5 years old. Living in the trailer in 8 Mile, damn.
Since a 5-year-old, it was I alone. Since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back how bad it was then, if it hadn't have been for the pad and the pin addict, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within. Having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be in.
He's basically saying, man, if it wasn't for how he came up, how he lived his life, he wouldn't be the best MC that he is. The greatest MC of all time, bro. You know? And that's why I tell people, listen, God works in mysterious ways, bro. Y'all might question your life. You might question why things are the way they are. But all it is giving you the strength, experience, the lessons that you need to be successful in life. So no matter what situation you're in, if you're down, you might not understand why. You might be upset. You might cry. You might be mad at God. But just trust God's process, bro. God's timing is perfect. And you can never question it, man. He knows what he's doing. If Eminem would have not grew up in this trailer park, if he would have not had the parents he had, the mom, and the experiences that he'd been in, you think he would be the rapper he is today? I don't think so. Y'all let me know what y'all think, but I think he's grateful for what he'd been through. He just said it. If it wasn't for that and the pad and the pen, it wouldn't make me the savage I have within. You know, like, come on. Bring that back.
Water down. You gotta take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode since a 5-year-old. Was I alone since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back how bad it was then, if it hadn't have been for the pad and the pin. Addict mom and dad beat dad, I would have had the savage within. Having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMD must have had teaching.
Tediously I wrote obediently. Tediously, like, all the time. Like, it's a hard, like, putting in that work, you know what I'm saying? Hard work. Like, I just wrote all the time obediently. Like, he was faithful. He stuck to his grind, dedication. You know what I'm saying? A lot of y'all just get in the booth and spit whatever. Y'all don't really take the time out to hone your craft. Actually get better at wordplay, bars, vocabulary, reading the dictionary, and actually saying some shit that matters and means something. Because nowadays everybody just saying the same shit over and over again, bro. And that's a fact.
I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMD must have had teaching degrees, learned to defeat
teaching
enemies.
Degrees
the thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E, and graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. Yeah. To my last breath, these my lungs are
graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. Come on, bro. This guy could teach a college course on MCN 101, bro. Like, Eminem is a motherfucking, he's the headmaster of this fucking school of rappers, bro. I don't know.
Would be as easy as E, and graffiti would be like remedial reading
to me.
To my last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. Yeah. The east side slums, gotta remind them, I'll take a foe out like feet by thumb. You see my finger, you see my thumb.
I'll take a foe out like feet by foe. Feet by thumb. I'll take a foe out. Come on, you get it. I don't gotta explain it.
My last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. Yeah. The east side slums, gotta remind them, I'll take a foe out like feet by foe. You see my finger, you see my thumb, you see my fist for a peace pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung, for the beef I've come. But you better bring it if you wanna reply from. Cause for you to be lyrically inclined, it'd be a steep climb up.
He said you better bring it if you wanna reply from. Cause for you to bring it, it'll be a lyrical steep climb. I think he's talking about Lil Pump. Well, this is probably, I don't know if this song got to be on the album. I haven't heard it yet. And Pump came out the woodwork earlier talking shit about M. Little Pump, you're fucking trash. Like, why would you even disrespect this man? You want attention, bro. Like, you dissing him for clout. Like, you cannot fuck with Eminem on no type of time. Like, cut it out, fam.
To be lyrically inclined, it'd be a steep climb up. That'll be an uphill battle, but I'm up like your feet
uphill
in a
battle.
And I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher, cause
I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Come on, fam.
Inclined,
inclined. It'd be a steep climb up. That'll be an uphill battle, but I'm up like your feet in a recliner. And I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher, cause
where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. To go from here, okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Bam. This right here is that motivation music, man. Eminem is great when he does the motivation music. This is an anthem. This could be played on the radio. This song right here is so versatile because you're getting the flows, you're getting the vocabulary, you're getting the wordplay, you're getting the bars, the metaphors, you're getting vintage M. He's like Ultra Instinct Eminem. I can't even explain it, bro. This track right here is so good in so many different ways. You know, like, this could be played on the radio. It could be a single. This is still a lyrical masterpiece. Like, come on, man. I don't know what else to say. You know I'm rocking with it, man. I love Eminem. My favorite rapper, my favorite rapper was Eminem. And then when he brought 50 out, I became a diehard 50 G-Unit fan. A stan, I'm gonna be honest. I was a G-Unit stan. And to this day, Lloyd Banks is my favorite. But it happened that way. M, 50 Banks. Like, I'll take those three over anybody, any day. Anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think about this in the comments down below. If you're new to the channel, hit the like button, subscribe. If you have any other videos you would like me to react to, recommend it in the comments. It's your boy Dollars. I'ma holla. I'm out.